happy Mother's Day to all of you out there that are mothers or influential women in this day and age, especially with the things that are going on. Maternity love and gentleness and encouragement is what we're all in need of, at least I myself. But I just wanted to put out this video that was very raw, very personal, very real, so that today would be a day that you would celebrate in the midst of your memories, those that are good and those that are bad, those that have been hard. But I come from a place where it has served me well to be as open and as honest about my life. It might not have always been the most popular thing, but this is my gift to you, because I want you to know that there's hope for you as well. And so this is my story, as I've asked the other women to share, that being a mom has been the greatest joy that I could ever imagine. I have three beautiful daughters, April Marie, Rachel Elizabeth, and Victoria Rose. Now, I'm not going to state their ages, because they are grown women, and at this point, once you turn 21, we don't talk about age anymore. And so, but they are all successful. They've all, gone to school, and they all strive. They have families. They've all been married. I have a grandson with April Marie and her husband Jeremy. They live up in Northern California. Rachel is here locally, and Victoria, I believe, is up in the Lake Forest area. So she's not too far, but hopefully this reaches her as well, because I do want them to all know how much I love them and admire them all. They have been my greatest joy. Now, I gotta read off this script or else we'll never get through this. So, here's my story. When it came to being a mother, I was imperfect and made many mistakes. My mother was a great mom, but due to the times that we were living in, she was working. So I grew up a latchkey kid, and even more so when my parents divorced. Even as a young girl, I had an adventurous spirit and a heart of compassion for the hurting, the neglected, and the misfits. And obviously, I was like one of them. I was a young girl with big dreams, but nothing worked out the way I thought it would. But through it all, I realized that God had his own plan for me. And I have a life verse that I'm going to share, because it's a verse I've heard many, many times over. And many people use it, but truly this became my life verse, where I had a glimmer of hope that there was faith and there was something more for me. And it's Jeremiah 29:11, and it says, "For I know the plans that I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, but plans to give you a hope and a future." And that's what he's done for me. My ways ended when I met my husband of 32 years, and we headed into a journey where our whole life mission would be to the hurting, to the neglected, and the misfits. My girls are all grown up and realizing many of the dreams that I had for my own life. Still, I get to realize those dreams through them. And what joy it has been to watch them soar. There have been a number of women who have been willing to pour into my life through the years in a maternal way, and I'm grateful for every one of them. I'm actually eternally grateful for every one of them. They taught me the power of faith, hope, and love, which has served me well as a mother over the years. Now that my children are grown and out on their own, I never stopped being a mother. Just so you know, I'm going to do a stop right here, because Howard's in the background asking me to yell louder. So that'll get me out of my crying jag here. So anyway, but now that my children are grown and out on their own, I've never stopped being a mother. While reflecting on this project, just this morning, I've discovered that I'm still a mother, but to all kinds of people. Today, I have surrounded myself with grandmothers, mothers, and daughters who have poured into my life and have changed me. I am proud to be part of this village of faith, hope, and love that sees beyond the facades and fears and encourages us all to look beyond what we see. This comes from a place deep inside of me, as I've never really fit in, but I know I was never meant to fit in, and that it was all part of the plan. It was to be courageous, to see beyond real life circumstances, and not to run from it. I do pray that today you will be encouraged by the study that is brought forth, and that you do feel special as a mother, even if you haven't had your own kids. I know that you're working women, that you run households, that you run companies, that you manage people, that you deal with your neighbors and even the mailman, and remembering to give him a card because you've become such good friends. Those are the things that mothers really think about. No one else even thought it would give two thoughts to. And it's just because of where we've been, what we've been through. And I'll tell you, as life has been difficult, and I have made those mistakes, and we all have, I just pray that the encouragement today is to never stop trying and to not lose hope, to have faith, and to be encouraged. We're not called to fit in and to be perfect. So I want to encourage you in that today.